So I saw this pretty interesting law school marketing email posted on an LSAT message board the other day, and I wanted to share some comments with you on it and what it means. So the Florida Coastal School of Law sent out an email after the November LSAT scores were released, and here's what it says. Hi, my name is Tony Cardenas, and I'm the Dean of Admissions and Marketing at Florida Coastal School of Law. We received your November LSAT score and noticed you scored a 162. Well done and congratulations. So again, that was an email sent out to one law school applicant after the November LSAT. And this law school, Florida Coastal, apparently already has this applicant's LSAT scores. But despite that, that applicant will have to pay LSAC a fee of $45 for the credential assembly service fee per law school, sending your LSAT scores and application to each specific law school to which you're applying, which is basically LSAC taking the score that you've already paid to get, because remember, you paid an LSAT registration fee of nearly $200. On top of that, you'll then have to pay another $45 fee to send your information to each specific law school. And the funny thing is, LSAC has already released this applicant's LSAT score to Florida Coastal for marketing purposes, and maybe the law school paid LSAC a fee as well for that service. But either way, the fact that this law school has a dean of admissions and marketing is itself kind of funny, because law schools are in fact a business, and admissions and marketing are often just two sides of the same coin. Law schools want as many applications as possible, because the more applications they receive, the lower their acceptance rate will be, the more selective they will appear. And a school like Florida Coastal, I'm sure they would be thrilled to get an applicant like this one with a 162. And maybe that's why they may have paid LSAC to get that applicant's score in advance. I kind of view LSAC's role in this like the role of Ticketmaster in the concert business. Ticketmaster is the scapegoat for high fees that are charged on top of the ticket price themselves, but then the part of that Ticketmaster fee actually goes back to the venue and goes back to the concert performers themselves. So Ticketmaster, again, gets all the bad blood, gets all the bad connotations and associations, but they're just taking that money, putting it aside, and again, a lot of that's going back to the concert promoters, to the venues themselves. And similarly, I think it's easy to blame LSAC for this, all those high fees, but again, LSAC is acting on behalf of the law schools. It's the Law School Admission Council. It's a umbrella organization serving law schools, not law school applicants. So I think that's important to keep in mind here. Either way, I hope that LSAC will lower its fees. I hope they will find a way to rework this in a way that works better for everyone, both law school applicants and law schools alike. And I hope that Florida Coastal doesn't make people send over their information and pay $45 to do so when they've already received it. I know that that's the way things are structured and that's the way they'll likely continue, but I do think either way, it's good to be aware of what's going on, because you are a consumer in this process, not just a law school applicant. Anyway, I wish you all the best as you apply to law school. Please feel free if you need anything, if you have any questions. I'm here and happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.